Welcome back. If it's Friday, that means there's a new episode of our streaming show, Meet the Press Reports, available on demand on Peacock. This week, we're taking a deep dive into the modern-day space race. It's not just about billionaires sending themselves into orbit. Private businesses are now leveraging new technology to do things that only NASA used to be able to do, and they're making money while they're at it. NBC's Jacob Ward has more. Jacob?
Garrett, I know it's strange to be with you talking about space from where I am, San Francisco, but the truth is, in the same way that this place has become a growing bed of activity when it comes to startups and all the other spaces, it is also a startup hub for space. There is, in fact, an operations center, the kind of thing that you would only see at NASA a few decades ago, located just a few blocks from where I'm standing. It belongs to a company that now sells data from a fleet of satellites that it maintains in space. And we went inside to have a look.
Why is data from space so valuable? Well, think about it this way. If you're an agricultural company looking to make farms more productive, you could put up a drone and scan a couple hundred acres to see which plants look dry, sure. Or you could buy imagery from a satellite that can see 700 million acres for about 100 times less money. Affordable daily satellite imagery is also a vital weapon against climate change. Why? Because until now, we just didn't have enough data to see the change happening in real time.
We can't stop deforestation if we're only measuring it every year, if the deforestation happens on days. Same with emissions, same with agriculture, and same with all of these things. You need data on the time scale of change to take care of it.
The principle of Planet is that anyone, aside from terrorist organizations and embargoed nations, can buy these images. Clients can even task a handful of these larger satellites with special jobs and keep the footage exclusive for a period of time. Academics and private sector analysts using these satellites have pulled huge geopolitical threats into the public eye that previously only an intelligence agency would have known about.
We found a set of about 100 nuclear weapons silos in China that were previously undisclosed. That's an important, you know, deal, of course. We actually found them in our scanning fleet and then took a closer look with these.
And that was you selling that imagery to...
In this case, think tanks that were taking a look at it. No, so not the government.
But, not even the government was buying it.
Yeah.
Now, Garrett, if you're looking at a world in which suddenly these private corporations are not only going to space, but determining what we get to see from there, what role does NASA have? Well, NASA is going to continue, it says, to have this exploratory mission. And there are all sorts of things that they will do that a private company would never do. In fact, they announced this week that next month they're going to be launching a whole mission to look at the possibility of knocking deadly asteroids off course, asteroids that might otherwise reach us. Nothing is currently threatening us, but that's the experiment they'll be doing. But of course, how are they going to get that experiment up there? Well, it's going to go up on a SpaceX Falcon 9 rocket. We're seeing this new world in which data, rockets themselves, and the science are all blending together in this public and private world. Garrett?
Asteroids, the arcade game, now in real life. Jacob Ward there. We can see more of Jacob's reporting, plus Chuck's conversation with the NASA administrator and an astronaut on the latest episode of Meet the Press Reports. That's available right now on demand on Peacock.